So here we're going to use a Barb 3 along the jawline to get lift through here. This is really common. People complain about the neck and loose skin and platysma banding from the age of 30 on. And I'm using a 20 gauge needle, and what we're gonna do is create an opening here, a little poke. And if you want to, you can use a little lidocaine with epinephrine to create an area here, but really it doesn't even bleed or bruise down there. But sometimes it does add a bit of comfort for the patient. Now this is really nice. We used to use Barb 1s. A lot of people are disappointed to see them go. The Barb 3s are an improvement. Here's the opening. Bevel up, okay, to put it in, and then bevel down. And now I'm stretching the skin. Again, traction here. This is my end point. We used to come in here and go all the way across, but now I like treating along the edge here. Okay. So we're pushing through. We're pushing along. It's pretty easy to push through here. And this is my endpoint. Now, right near that platysma band, and you can see it go through. This is a cannula, it's not a needle. So they almost never bruise. At the end, now, I need to engage it because it's a barb. This is key. I feel the end of the metal. A lot of people will follow the metal up as they pull it out, but really it's engaging the end of the thread. A twist right and left. Use at least two fingers. Not on the metal, but where the thread is. And then we're gonna lift through, and that will engage beautifully. These Barb 3s are great. Now, here's my thread. I can pull it, and you can see it tighten there. And now I'm gonna do one pull here to engage those barbs and really create a concavity at that neck, which is what people wanna see. They want no loose skin. And you can tighten that to the level you want. I'm pretty happy there. So I'm gonna take the scissors. And this is very, very important. What I'm doing, I'm pushing down, but I'm not, first of all, I don't want that much of the scissors open. Okay, I want just a tiny bit so I don't get the skin. You'll never bruise them if you don't cut them. And I'm pushing down on the skin, cutting, and that buries the thread. And then I'm massaging up to further engage it. And you can see we've created a nice jawline here. So we're cleansing, we're trying to go to that platysma band to create the opening again with this 20 gauge needle. We don't have to put it in very far, it's the dermis we're trying to get. And you'll almost never see blood in that area. So we get our Barb 3, 2.5 inch, and sometimes you can squeeze it to get a little drop of blood so you can find the opening. Often that can be a problem, just finding where you went. Bevel down, and now you can see it track through the tissues. You wanna be not too deep and not too superficial. It's a cannula, so it's really hard to get too superficial. It's pretty easy to be in the right plane as long as you're not deep. And now I'm just pushing the skin. I'm holding it where the thread is. So I'm feeling where the metal is. I hold it and then I twist it to engage it. And then I can feel it engage and I'm pulling out. And here's my thread, I grab it, pull to the level I want, engage it a little bit further because I want more lift. I can feel the barbs and pull it to where I want the tightness. And that's right about where I want it. Now, I'm gonna clip that, avoiding clipping the skin, pushing down on the thread, clipping, and giving a last engagement of those barbs up. They'll never bruise, they'll never see the opening, they have to keep it clean.